Grizzlies, Mr. Calder here to advertise probability and statistics and AP statistics and why you should take the class. Reason number one, you can win this sweet fantasy football trophy if you're the best of the best. If that doesn't excite you, let's look at some information that might. Highlighted here, work in statistics, the number six best job in 2020, according to U.S. News, the number seven fastest growing job, according to the U.S. Bureau of Labor and Statistics. I listed four jobs there that require statistics, all of them six figures or more. These jobs are in high demand and pay you lots of money. That's why you take statistics. Let's look at another website here, the 30 best high-paying jobs of the future. I'm going to just start scrolling down here. Let's start here at number 14, where we see computer systems analyst. Let's jump to number 8, where we see management analyst. Number 7, market research analyst and marketing specialist. How about number 1? Software developer and software quality assurance analyst and tester. Guys, if you know how to analyze and interpret data, make good decisions, you will make lots and lots of money. In fact, I'm not sure why I'm making this video. I'm about to go apply for one of these statistics jobs. See ya.
Drop my hot pocket.
All right, hi, I am Ms. Shelton. I'm here to talk about the science elective Chemistry 2. Chemistry 2 is a one semester science elective. You should have taken chemistry regular or honors and passed ideally with an A or a B. And you should have taken or be in, but ideally have already finished Algebra 2. Because there's a medium amount of math and it's mostly algebra related. It doesn't have college credit, but it does get GPA weighted like an honors class because it is a science elective. So what are we gonna talk about in Chemistry 2? Since you have the foundational stuff, we can talk about the applications of chemistry. So how you use chemistry to make energy, how it's related to medicine, engineering, the environment, all sorts of really cool stuff. So we're planning on doing lots of awesome labs we don't get to do in Chem 1, like talking about the chemistry behind forging and smelting and quenching of metals, ceramics and glazes and the chemistry behind a lot of art stuff. Growing crystals, medicinal chemistry, agricultural and green chemistry, and environmental stuff. We have so many options. I'm not entirely sure how we're going to do them all, but it should be a very, very fun class for those students that already have a solid grasp of regular chemistry, and we can just kind of take it further into the application of it. So if you think that it's something that sounds interesting to you, please sign up for it. You can always come talk to us about it if you want to learn more. I hope to see you guys in my class.